Ladies and gentlemen, fellow Earthlings, and who knows, future space explorers. When we start talking about space, there's always have been this big lie they told us since day one. And before anyone think of it, no, I'm not talking about the shape of our planet. Last time I checked, it's still round. And yeah, I hear something about no, what I will try to talk about, and the real issue is, they told us that space is just for some elites. So astronauts, space agencies, big old companies with their view locked up in the rearview mirror, and even quite recently, the billionaires. And I quite felt for that too. But if you listen to me in the next couple of minutes, I'll try to elaborate and explain. I'm Hady Milani, and I'm the scientific director of the Space Entrepreneurship Program at the European Institute of Innovation for Sustainability. And what I do on a daily basis is try to help and foster in sustainable innovation inside the space sector and helping big companies like Airbus and also European Space Agency to solve challenges. And how we do so? We do it by putting together space and non-space people, giving them knowledge, tool, network, and make them work on something. And innovation happens between the lines. And I've got, let's say, a front row seat inside the space industry. And one thing I can tell you is usually big old space companies are doing the same old things in the same old way, but they expect new results. And I think that's naive. Of course, there have been a lot of improvements in matter of sustainability, in matter of safety, even reliability, and that's great. And that's also thanks to new policies that we are witnessing right now, when we see the private and the public sector working together in order to solve challenges and problems in what many people call the new space economy. But even that, you have to consider that new space companies also have to fit in and abide by the rules of this old companies. And as you can see, we are stuck in a space-time continuum loop, repeating the same tried trajectories. And where, while the universe is trying to, you know, beckons us to break these guidelines and explore the unknown. And I tried to be inspirational in this phrase, because at the end, space is inspirational. I myself decided to get in the space industry because it is. And one thing that I usually think about when you talk about, you know, space is recalling the glorious era of the early space exploration. What changed from there? We were explorers, we were pioneers, we were daring to go somewhere and place it that we've never done before, we've never gone before. What changed? So in the process, I think we got too comfortable. We settled for incremental improvements. We were happy to see our rockets sleeker and our satellites smarter. But you know, the innovation per se does not happen just with efficiency and timing. One thing to be considered when we want to do a project, specifically not just in space, but also other things, is a step before. When we think of doing something, the step before is mostly on a forma mentis. It's how we approach the problem, how we set our goals. I will try to give an example in order to make myself clearer. Just imagine if I come to you and I told you that I want to go from a point A to a point B, let's say they're separated by 100 kilometers, right? And I told you that I want to go from this distance within 2 to 3 days. You will probably advise me to, okay, Hady, you can do it even by walk. I might. But then I'll come to you again and say, no, I want to do this period I mean, I want to do this in a period of time in one day. And you probably say, Hady, maybe better if you use a bicycle. Again, I'll come back and say, look, I want to do this distance in around 1 hour. You probably lend me your keys of the car and say, OK, take a car. Change it again. I say, no, I want to do it in 20 minutes. And in that case, you would probably think of a plane, right? But here's the thing. All the things that we used are instruments or vehicles that we already have. And if I were to come to you again and say, I want to do it in less than 2 minutes, you probably either say that I'm crazy, or you will say, OK, let's think of something. Let's find a new solution. Teleportation, maybe? What I'm trying to say right now is, if I want to reach a point B from a point A, it is important to set the correct guidelines and to put also the correct goals. We need to ask ourselves the right questions. Because right now, what we see from the space industry itself is like, OK, I have this rocket, I have this spaceship, where can I go with it? How far can I reach? Instead of saying, I want to go to the moon, I want to go to Mars, in a couple of set years, what do I need? So we decided to go to the moon, and we found a way. This is something that we should start doing this even now. What I'm telling this, I'm telling this here now, today, on this platform, because never before there have been so many opportunities for people to join this new space era. Right now, we are witnessing also new space companies that are paving the way for new exploration, for new technologies, and expanding the human domain in space. And this is great, but it doesn't stop here. One thing that I usually tell to people is right now, like, internet in the 90s is like space right now. So there's tons of opportunities that people can get, right? And what could be possibly your role? I can give you two options that I think of. First of all, you can be conscious users. Right now, you have GPS, for example, on your pocket, and you can use it. That goes, again, from GPS or the filtered water you drink, and the connectivity you use, or the medical procedures that you undergo. So these things that come from the space industry and are on your daily life should be understood. And that could be also in contrast with the effect of dumbing down. So one thing that could happen is we can rise and engage with this information and rise awareness and try to make them intellectually stimulating in order for people to understand much better. And by doing so, there's also the other option. You can either be an active player. You can, in your own field, you can find some technologies that can enable the space exploration. Or there might be some breakthrough technology from the space industry that you can use in your own sector. And that's when you can be an active player. And what I'm saying is that when you think of it, when we want to go and explore and expand our domain in space, and we want to be an interplanetary species, we can all understand that if we want to sustain life somewhere else, we need to have an honest representation of human population. So, of course, yes, we need engineers, we need scientists, but we also need gardeners, carpenters, plumbers, scientists, doctors, teachers. So yes, when I say they told us a very big lie that space is for just an elite, astronauts, billionaires, I'm here to tell you the real cosmic truth. Space is for us. It's for all of us. And space technology, if you think, it's seeping its way into our daily life. Again, from satellite connectivity to Earth observation to any technologies that help us improve our daily life, we see that, we perceive that. And it does it stop here? As my dream mentor would say, job done? No, job's not finished. And this is something that we need to consider. What else we can do? At the end, we are not just passengers on this blue marble that is hurtling in the vastness of space. We are the crew, we are the engineers, we are the stargazers. And we have the power to change not just the future of space exploration, but also use that in order to enhance and make better life here on Earth. So let me leave you with this thought. It's time to embrace our cosmic citizenship. Take some bold actions and go some places that has never been gone. And not just with our rockets, but we have our minds, we have our hearts, and with our collective imagination. Because at the end, if you think of it, aren't we all just astronauts on the spaceship Earth? Thank you.